Shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel. Once again, it's another video, and it comes to you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem, Rekah Kodash. All praises and glories definitely do, especially in these times. So this is another example of this so-called white man, Esau Edom, being exposed, just like the Apostle Paul said he would be in the last days, okay? This has to do with the so-called Apollo moon mission, all right? The landing of the Apollo on the moon back in July of 1969, I believe it was. And basically, one of the men that was behind filming it, okay, Stanley Kubrick, comes out and reveals that it was a hoax, and this is shortly before his death. All right, so now the film or the footage has surfaced, and I got a couple of examples which goes into that. You're looking at the first example here, entitled Stanley Kubrick Admits to Faking the Apollo Moon Landing. Now remember what the scriptures say about this man, this so-called white man, Esau Edom. This is the book of Job 13 and 4. It says, "But ye are forgers of lies. Ye are physicians," or "ye are all physicians of no value." Now, when you look at that word forger or forgers in the Hebrew, the word there is tapal, and it says to smear, plaster over, stick, glue. And down here in the Jesenuis Hebrew Chaldee lexicon, it says to patch, figuratively to frame lies. Now what you're about to see was a big hoax. It was a big lie. Esau never went to the moon. And one of the main guys behind it, Stanley Kubrick, who helped film it, who helped develop the sound stage that was used to simulate Esau being on the moon, comes out and reveals it. And this is that scripture where it speaks about in the latter days. As a matter of fact, let's go to that. The book of Psalm 64. Let's see what that says. Psalm 64, and start the fifth verse. It says, "They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privately. They say, who shall see them?" And for a lot of years, that so-called moon mission was a secret. But now the secret is blown wide open. As a matter of fact, I forgot the guy's name. He directed a documentary called A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Moon. And basically in that documentary, he reveals that the moon landing was fake. And I believe the same individual who put that documentary together, he tried to interview, I think it was Buzz Aldrin, and they show you that in the documentary, and they almost got into a fight, okay? And I think it was Buzz Aldrin who said, "Do you want me to knock you in the head?" Because this guy was trying to interview Buzz Aldrin, who was part of the Apollo moon mission back in 69, and trying to interview him and ask him, "Why did you fake the moon landing?" And that's when, well, I believe it was Buzz Aldrin, that's when he lost it, okay? And, you know, you can see what happened there. Try to get that documentary, A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Moon, and you can put the link in the description box, you brothers out there. You know, we're in the time of this man being exposed, okay? All his lies, his sandcastle of lies are being knocked down, okay? And this is just one more example, that so-called moon landing. Let's read on. It says, "They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privately. They say, who shall see them? They search out iniquities. They accomplish a diligent search. Both the inward thought of every one of them and the heart is deep. But the heavenly Father shall shoot at them with an arrow. Suddenly shall they be wounded." What does it mean, suddenly shall they be wounded? Meaning they're going to be exposed. And this is just another example, this video that I'm doing here, exposing the so-called moon landing, which was fake to begin with. Let's read on. So they shall make their own tongue to fall upon themselves. And you're about to see an example of that, where Stanley Kubrick comes out and said that it was a hoax. He said that his conscience was bothering him. Okay, and I read somewhere or I saw a video where Stanley Kubrick, who was famous in Hollywood for directing movies like The Shining, which the movie The Shining is really about the moon landing, how it was fake. You know, Jack Nicholson, who played in the movie, was supposed to be Kubrick. And Shelley Duvall, who played Nicholson's wife in the movie, was supposed to be Kubrick's wife. He also directed Full Metal Jacket, which is another good movie. All right. Kubrick was one of those guys, one of the insiders who came and blew a whistle on the whole project, all right? And just shortly before his death. But that links with this scripture here, Psalm 64 and 8. So they shall make their own tongue to fall upon themselves. All that see them shall flee away. There you go. And all men shall fear and shall declare the work of the Heavenly Father. Yeah, because the Heavenly Father is using us as Israelite men, you know, that know this truth, using us to expose this so-called white man, to expose this devil. Going back to 2 Thessalonians, where it says, the man of sin be revealed, okay? And all his lies, okay? And all men shall fear and shall declare the work of the Heavenly Father, for they shall wisely consider of his doing. This is the Heavenly Father's doing, to expose this man. So let's get into the exposure. Okay, without further ado, let's take a look at this piece of footage here. Stanley Kubrick admits to faking the Apollo moon landing.
On World News Tonight, this Sunday, one of the world's greatest filmmakers has died.
Will you stop, Dave?
Tonight, we remember Stanley Kubrick's visual legacy.
I am Werner von Braun. This motion picture was produced to enable you to experience more personally and vividly the most dramatic events of the Apollo 11 story. The pictures and sounds are real, recorded in real time, where the action really was. So, come with us. We are going to the moon.
And I'm sure you've heard the rumors.
The moon landing?
Okay.
That's right. The
old guy you see there, that's Kubrick. All right, many years later, and you can see he looks real haggard. He was in fear for his life. All right, somewhere I read, or maybe I saw the video, he carried a shotgun, you know, and he lived like a recluse. I believe the word is recluse, where he pretty much lived in fear for the rest of his life because he knew too much about that moon program. Also, one of the last movies he directed, Eyes Wide Shut, starring Tom Cruise, in that movie he exposes the sexual depravity of the top elite, you know, the things that they get into sexual-wise, okay, a lot of deviancy. And I guess the powers that be had enough of him, and I think they just silenced him. Because right after that movie, not too long after that movie, he passed away. Kubrick, all right? He was already in failing health anyway. So there you go. But again, Psalm 64, man. The Heavenly Father is making their own tongue to fall upon themselves. So let's watch some more.
Landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person.
Did you hear that? All the moon landings were fake. And that explains why in 2021, this man hasn't been able to go to the moon. He still hasn't been to the moon. Okay? Wow.
You're serious? And okay.
I am serious. Yeah. I'm dead serious.
Because I only have this certain amount of time with you, and I'll talk about whatever you want. You know, this isn't some type of joke or
no, it's not
film within a film thing?
Not a joke. Nope.
Okay.
The conspiracy theorists were right on this occasion.
Why?
I don't know about Paul McCartney's death, but this they were right about.
Okay. Why in God's name would... I don't know what to ask you first. Why the hell, if you're telling the truth, why would you do it? Why are you telling me? I mean, what the...
Don't you think it's important for people to know the truth?
Yeah, I got yes, certainly.
They had a massive...
One of the reasons why they did it is because back in 1969, well, during the 60s, there was a space race between Russia and America. And America wanted to beat Russia, so America fabricated going to the moon. You know, Russia had already put out satellites in outer space. One of them was called Sputnik. And, you know, America couldn't be outdone by Russia, so America trumps one better and they go to the moon. But it was all fake. You just heard Kubrick said all the moon landings were fake. Not to mention the set that they used to film that illusion was plagued with many problems. Okay, I remember seeing a documentary on that. So Esau is just a big liar. His power is deception, and he's being exposed.
Fraud, an unparalleled fraud perpetrated against them.
Unparalleled fraud.
Know. Okay.
Unparalleled fraud. Let's bring in the scripture here, man. James, the fifth chapter. This man is, and then you're going to, you Israelites out there, you're going to take that stab and jab because you've been told by that clown, General Yohanna, to go and take it. And you're going to go and put your life in the hand of a man that's a master of fraud. Let's read this here. James 5 and 4. Behold, the hire of the laborers who have reaped down your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud. Another example of fraud is the whole money system is based upon fraud. The Federal Reserve was created by fraud. Okay, it was created in secret, by the way. The Federal Reserve Act. You know what happened there on Jekyll Island near Georgia in 1910, where those devils got together and created the Federal Reserve, which later would become law. And what they did was they created a machine to rip the people off, to get their labor and give them nothing for their labor, give them instruments of no value for something of value, which is their labor. That's what we have now. We have this so-called paper dollar, which is an instrument of really no value because it's being devalued by the second. Right now, the buying power of the dollar bill is what? 1, maybe 2 cents. Okay, so it's all fraud. It's gigantic fraud. And that moon landing is another example of fraud. Let's read again, James 5 and 4. Behold, the hire of the laborers who have reaped down your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud, crieth. And the cries of them which have reaped are entered into the ears of the Lord of Sabaoth. This man has ripped everybody off, including his own kind. Okay, starting, this scripture here is going, is exposing the top banking families. Because when you read the first verse, it says, go to now ye rich men. The rich men is talking about the top banking families, the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, Oppenheimers, who no doubt had a hand in that moon landing as well. Finance guys like Stanley Kubrick. But here Kubrick is, he's coming against them. He's exposing them. Let's watch some more.
I mean, they're already suspicious of the government. They may as well have their suspicions confirmed.
Okay.
Justified.
Wow.
And this, why now? I mean, we're almost at the 30-year anniversary. What took so long? Why, if this is true, why?
I won't go into that. It has to do with personal...
Okay.
Of evolution and influences.
And, well,
I'll go into that.
Is that why you look a little haggard right now? Because you look a little worn, no offense. Like.
Well, also, yeah, because I haven't been taking care of myself too well. I've been drinking a lot, but...
Is that because of the stress of this?
Of course. Stress, guilt, just conflict of all kinds.
Wow, I mean, so you feel bad about this, clearly. I mean, this is...
I do feel bad about it. I also feel proud of it. It's a terrible conflict.
Because you've pulled off one of the greatest hoaxes ever because of
And because I made a film if you want to call it a film, which I consider to be my masterpiece.
There you go. There you go. So this man is being exposed, brothers, and you few sisters that watch these videos. Every level he's being exposed. Let's bring in 2 Thessalonians 2 and 7. Well, actually 2 and 3. It says, let no man deceive you by any means. And we were deceived by that so-called moon landing for many years. We actually thought they really went to the moon when we saw the footage, you know, with that raggedy spaceship that they had supposedly made it all the way to the moon. You know, when they had interviewed, I think it was Buzz Aldrin, one of the astronauts, he said that they went through the Van Allen belt. Now Google that, James Van Allen. The Van Allen belt was named after James Van Allen. The Van Allen belt stretches about 1,000 miles above the Earth and stretches for about 25,000 miles. From 1,000 miles above the Earth and another 25,000 miles is a belt of pure radiation that goes around the Earth to help protect the Earth. So when they were asked, one of the astronauts, how did you get through the Van Allen belt? They said, oh, we just went through it. So you mean to tell me if that raggedy-ass spaceship back in 1969, they went through 25,000 miles of pure radiation without being affected? Yeah, okay. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. There you go. There's also a scripture where he said he will, I will be like the Most High. What is that? Ezekiel 28. Let me see that. If that's it. Then I'm going to show you the other footage I got. Ezekiel 28 and 1, it says, the word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, son of man, say unto the prince of Tyrus, which is, you know, pretty much represents Esau, Edom, thus saith the Lord, power, because thine heart is lifted up. Sounds like Esau to me. Obadiah confirms that. The pride of thine heart have deceived thee, thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock. They call himself Caucasian. Okay, Caucasian means cave dweller. Because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am a god. I sit in the seat of God in the midst of the seas. And that so-called moon landing did make Esau look to be a god. You know, a lot of people were looking up to the so-called white man. He actually made it to the moon. Wow. And now we're finding out it was fake. It's all a big hoax. Just like the Wizard of Oz. Because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am a god. I sit in the seat of God in the midst of the seas. Yet thou art a man and not God, though thou set thine heart as the heart of God. Behold, thou art wiser than Daniel. There is no secret they can hide from thee. Yeah. And for him to pull off that great hoax, he was pretty wise. But now he's being exposed. Okay. So let's look at the other piece of footage I got. All right, this is entitled Moon Shining. And that goes back to the movie, The Shining, where they reveal a lot of things in the movie, The Shining. Show you that the moon landing was fake. Anyway, how Stanley Kubrick shot the Apollo 11 mission.
I am Werner von Braun. This motion picture was produced to enable you to experience more personally and vividly the most dramatic events of the Apollo 11 story. The pictures and sounds are real, recorded in real time, where the action really was. So, come with us. We are going to the moon.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition sequence start.
We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
I think it means that the job of landing something on the moon where there's no atmosphere and using a rocket to slow it up and having the equipment still work is a very difficult job.
We've been brought in here by Stanley Kubrick to more or less ensure the scientific integrity of the film, to make sure that it's...
Kubrick put his head down. Even back then, his conscience was beating him.
Very, very close in reality, but still, we want to make certain that it has a base of reality.
Before the end of the 60s, we will see a man on the moon, to the moon, an American, and we're very proud that our country continues to produce these...
See, Kennedy said that to give the Americans the shot in the arm, because at that time, there was a space race between America and Russia. So they, once again, America had to look good. You know, there's a scripture where it speaks about being stout. Let me see if I can find that. You know, America always has to look good, no matter what, even if it's a lie. let me see, is this it? Daniel 7 and 20? Daniel 7 and 20, and of the 10 horns that were in his head, and of the other which came up, and before whom 3 fell, even of that horn that had eyes and a mouth that spake very great things, whose look was more stout than his fellows. Yeah, talking about America. And that's an example. You know, the space race, America had to win. And allegedly they beat Russia by sending their men to the moon, something Russia wasn't able to do. But it was a lie, okay? It was a big lie. All right, bear with me for a minute.
Young man who go so far and carry with them so much.
To put people on the moon and with enough fuel to enable them to return safely home to Earth requires a still larger and more powerful rocket, however.
Yeah, that's a good question. How the hell did they get off the moon? We saw how much energy it took for them to get to the moon, right? We saw that huge, what's the word I'm looking for? That huge rocket that they were in, right? That jettison pack. And when they got to the moon, supposedly they were in that little raggedy spaceship. Now, how the hell did they, what did they use to get off the moon to get back to the Earth? We didn't see no huge rocket or jettison pack on the moon that they would have used to get back to the Earth. The whole thing was an elaborate hoax. Just like 9/11 was an elaborate hoax. Yeah, the buildings did come down, that's for sure, but the planes flying into the building and the Arabs attacking the building, all that, that was all BS, man. This man is being exposed.
It's going to take some time, and I think we have to recognize it. They secured these large boosters, which have led to their being first in Sputnik and led to their first putting their man in space. We are, I hope, going to be able to carry out our efforts with due regard to the problem of the life of the man involved this year. But
And you know what's funny? When those 3 astronauts got back to the Earth, now here it is, supposedly you just pulled off one of the greatest adventures on the planet Earth. You went to the moon. Man, when they were interviewing all 3 of those dudes, they looked like they just came back from a funeral. They didn't look happy. They didn't look joyous. They looked somber. Okay, there's a footage of that. You can find that on YouTube, where the first interview that they had of those men that took part in the Apollo 11 mission back in 1969, when they interviewed them back in 1969. Like I said, they looked like they just came back from a funeral. They didn't look happy at all. And supposedly you just pulled off one of the greatest missions on the planet Earth, going to the moon, and you look like that? Come on, man.
Far behind.
However, let us imagine for a moment that the many problems have been solved. We are ready to begin our first voyage to the moon.
It is quite possible that an aggressor nation that dominates space will then dominate the world.
We're in the final assembly building of the LAMP.
Aggressive nation then dominate the world. We just read the scripture, who had a more stout look than his fellows. Okay, it's always America. America got to be number one.
Sure, Rick and I have set ourselves several objectives. We hope to convey to the public the wonder and beauty and promise of the new age of exploration, which is opening up before the human race.
Arthur, here we are on the rim ship, and one can almost imagine we're on our way to the moon, or we've arrived at the moon, as a matter of fact.
Can you believe it? Can you?
We've arrived at the moon, as a matter of fact. Esau's a freaking liar, man.
Realize that we, that you and I, that all of us, have actually begun the exploration of another world.
Oh, man, look at that.
We have taken the first historic step into our solar system.
It's
one small step for man.
One giant leap for mankind.
We, the crew of Apollo 11, are privileged to represent the United States in our first attempt to take man to another heavenly body.
Man walks on the moon. The first man from Earth walked on the surface of the moon this morning, and the suspense here in London is unbelievable.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston.
Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
I'm going to step off the limb now.
Yeah, you brothers should check out the documentary, A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Moon. I forgot the name of the guy who directed it. They go into it even more. You know, the elaborate hoax that was the so-called moon landing.
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you, over.
Oh, boy.
That would be an honor. Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House. And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made in the whole history of man. All the people on this earth are truly one. One in their pride in what you have done. And one in our prayers that you will return safely to Earth.
And this is why the scriptures speak about their enchantments. Let's get that in Isaiah 47. I read that earlier this morning in the live show. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. That's America, man. America's being exposed, and then the only thing left for it is destruction by Yahweh Shai when he comes with those angels, with the so-called UFOs, the chariots. Now, that's real. Okay? Isaiah 47:1, come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. There's no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Let's go down to the third verse. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. And that was a shameful thing to perpetrate the hoax of going to the moon. That's why Stanley Kubrick was so messed up, as you saw in the first piece of footage. That's why he was so messed up. He said the American people got to know that it was a hoax, that I was behind it, you know. And he said that before he passed on. There's the scripture, thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, this is Yahweh Shai speaking. And I will not meet thee as a man. Why? Because Yahweh Shai is coming as this conquering power to wipe this place off the face of the earth, man. Let's jump down to the 10th verse. For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said, none seeth me. But now they're being exposed. Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it have perverted thee. And thou hast said in thine heart, I am and none else beside me. Yeah, there you go. 12th verse. Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries. What you just witnessed was enchantment, sorcery, witchcraft. Okay? Wherein thou hast labored from thy youth, if so, thou shalt be able to profit. If so, thou mayest prevail. Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee. And what is that? The missiles and the chariots. This place is done, man. This place is through. Okay, let's finish. Watch this. You know, all that pomp of America, America the Great and all, it's all BS, man. Nothing but a big fat hoax. Wait a minute, it was supposed to be on the moon. You can clearly see it was a set, a movie set, with Stanley Kubrick at the helm. There you go, hold on. There you go, look at that. Look at that, man. Look at that. Look at the set. And that's, there's Kubrick right there. Huh? You're through, America. You're through.
Presented by NASA.
And, you know, that's funny because Kubrick said that was his, at the same time, his greatest masterpiece, but at the same time, his greatest mistake. Anyway, hopefully you brothers were edified, and it's on to the next video. Shalom for now.